from Barcelona. I hope everybody is well. My name is Christian Griñán-Ferré. I am assistant professor at the Faculty of Pharmacy and Food Science from the University of Barcelona. Now I will explain a little about me, and after that I will talk about my research I have conducted in the Mercè Pallàs lab, in collaboration with several academic researchers and companies. Finally, I will talk about my main project in the field of epigenetic and drug discovery, the inhibition of the DNA-9 as a promising target for cognitive decline, published in the Aging Journal, titled Pharmacological Inhibition of DNA-9 Restores Cognition and Reduces Oxidative Stress, Neuroinflammation and Beta-Amyloid Plaques in an early-onset AD mouse model. This article is related with other articles that I published 4 years ago in the same journal, titled Epigenetic Mechanisms Underlying Cognitive Impairment and Alzheimer Disease Hallmark in 5X rat mice. I received my PhD in Epigenetic Modulation of Alzheimer Disease at the University of Barcelona 3 years ago, and a master's degree in anti-emphasis therapy at Omnia Molecular. As a result of my PhD, I demonstrate that during SAMP8 and 5-FIX fat senescence process, there are epigenetic mechanisms that could be under the accelerated aging and cognitive impairment, as well as that these processes are modulated by environmental factors as environmental enrichment and by drugs. Among them, I described some alterations in DNA-methylation, acetylation and their chromatin-modified enzymes, as well as in several microRNAs in hippocampal tissue in both strains in comparison with their respective healthy control mice. Some results were published in the Aging Journal as well. Furthermore, some of those alterations were corrected after environmental enrichment intervention or after DNA-9 inhibition treatment, which I will talk after. As a postdoc, I've been doing my first part at Neuropharmacology in Aging and Neurodegeneration Group in a multidisciplinary team in the field of medicinal chemistry, interested in the identification of new targets to achieve preventive or curative strategies by reducing inflammation, mitochondrial dysfunction, endoplasmatic reticulum stress, and oxidative stress in pathological senescence and the crossroad with epigenetics. Thus, I've initiated studies with new drug acting in putative new targets implicated in neuroinflammation with the group of Dr. Santiago Vázquez regarding the soluble epoxidrolate inhibitors, mitochondrial stress and oxidative stress with Dr. Carmen Escolano regarding diminution A2 receptors in pathological senescence and the crossroad with epigenetic with the DNA-9 inhibitor, among others. In parallel, I perform epigenetic studies with these mice and with a new murine model of Niemann-Pick type C disease, in collaboration with Dr. Daniel Greenberg to characterize epigenetic changes for this rare disease that may underlie cognitive impairment and neurodegeneration. Actually, I've initiated a new research line by using C. elegans model, an experience which I acquired in the last year after my postdoctoral stay in the laboratory of Dr. Chavasotti, PA of the stress group in Semmelweis University, as well as several mice models of neurodegeneration. The research interest is the development of new chemical entities based on epigenetics to ameliorate and prevent neurodegeneration disease, including brain-related disorders. I am also interested in the implication of the transgenerational epigenetic inheritance in the cognitive decline risk factor for the next generation. Likewise, the advanced research projects include DNA-9 GLP inhibitors and histone deacetylase inhibitors. Then, our research is framed in the field of neuroepigenetics. Growing evidence suggests that the epigenetic mechanism has been involved in the function of the CNS and has participated in neurodegenerative disorder. Interestingly, numerous advances in the pathophysiology of the AD regarding molecular pathways in gene expression and chromatin organization without changes in DNA sequence have been done. Therefore, better knowledge of epigenetic mechanisms may provide hints and clues in triggering and progression of AD. Inter-research in experimental models suggests that molecular intervention for modulating epigenetic mechanisms may have therapeutic applications to promote cognitive maintenance through an advanced age. Thus, the primary goal of the neuroepigenetic lab is to gain comprehension of how the epigenetic mechanisms modulate the CNS in response to the environment. Thus, in the epigenetic information give rise to the regulation of the expression, resulting in the development of several pathologies, including AD. Regarding the article recently published in the Aging Journal titled Pharmacological Inhibition of DNA-9 GLP Restore Cognition and Reduce Oxidative Stress, Neuroinflammation and Beta-Amyloid Plaques in an early-onset AD mouse model. Here, we want to perform the proof of concept of GNA9 GLP inhibition as a new approach to improve cognitive impairment presented by the AD. In this sense, it is important to highlight that the epigenetic regulation by the methyltransferase GNA9 is a crucial mechanism involved in learning and memory formation, and can alter the level of different factors promoting AD. In the cell, GNA9 forms a complex with GLP, which is responsible for the positive methyl groups to H3K9 in neurochromatin. This H3K9 methylation is an indicator of silent transcription on learning memory genes. The overexpression of GNA9 GLP complex and its repressive mark have been associated with synaptic plasticity deficiency, autophagy dysfunction, and an increase of oxidative stress and neuroinflammation. It is well known that several small molecules have been designed to inhibit this complex. The first dual GNA9 GLP inhibitor identified via high-throughput screening was VIX-1294. VIX-1294 is active in cell-based assays, reduce the levels of HK9 methylation at several GNA9 target genes. However, this compound presents high toxicity. To improve the therapeutic range, crystallography studies based on VIX-1294 allow the identification of other inhibitor compounds. On the one hand, Liu et al. Identified UNG-224 and UNG-321 in 2009. However, these compounds are less potent than VIX-1294 in cellular assays, owing to reduced cellular membrane permeability. Consequently, new structures with favorable potency in cell lines were also identified in 2006, UNG-646 and UNG-631. However, these inhibitors were non-effective in vivo studies. For that reason, the optimization of its pharmacokinetics properties led to identify UNG-642 and UNG-638, which are potent and selective GNA9 GLP inhibitors. In particular, UNG-642, a compound with AC50, less than 2.5 nanomolar and better pharmacological kinetics, making it a suitable compound for animal studies. It is an inhibitor with high potency in reducing H3K9 methylation to levels and low cell toxicity, more than 3,000 nanomolar. Regarding the in vivo PK properties, 5 mg kilo was shown to have Cmax in plasma, 1,000 nanograms milliliter and 68 nanograms milliliter in the brain, and was well tolerated. Furthermore, 5 mg kilo dose proved to be enough to inhibit GNA9 GLP activity in adult mice. Nevertheless, UNG-642, like other GNA9 GLP inhibitors, present a poor BBB permeability and very high melting points. In our case, we treated the 5 fixed-fact mice during 4 weeks with this compound at 5 mg kilo, and firstly, we found beneficial effects on behavior and cognitive after treatment. Next, we found reduced levels in main epigenetic repressive mark in 5 fixed-fact treated groups. In the same line, we found reduction in oxidative stress and neuroinflammation, and increased levels of synaptic markers and several neurotrophins such as BDNF, confirming the remarkable restoration of the cognition. Finally, we evaluate the effect of this compound treatment on β-Amyloid plaques, and we demonstrate a strong effect in reducing the number of β-Amyloid plaques. Thus, taken together, we conclude that GNA9 GLP inhibition has neuroprotective effects in a transgenic mouse model of early-onset Alzheimer's disease, being the first in vivo experiment, which demonstrates the association with the GNA9 inhibition and cognitive improvement. A really important insight. The next step regarding the drug discovery research is that we are designing and synthesizing a new family of GNA9 GLP inhibitors with better properties and PK/PD than the currently known inhibitors, in collaboration with several investigators. Of note, we are doing a setup of new methodology for the epigenetic experiments, such as RNA, CHIK, Mirna, and ATAC-seq, as well as we are conducting new techniques with C-elegans, like hemotaxia assay, toxicity assay, among others. And that's all. Thank you so much for this opportunity, and contact me for whatever you want. Thank you so much. Bye bye. See you.